Incredible things are happening in our solar system. Now and then, we are fortunate enough to welcome visitors from the deepest corners of the universe. And guess what? One of those visitors is making a comeback. Oumuamua suddenly showed up again and is now heading toward Earth. And what does this mean? It is the end for our solar system. Oumuamua, as astronomers named it, was quite peculiar because it had characteristics of an asteroid and a comet. Normally, gravitational interactions push away minor objects like comets and asteroids during the formation of planets around stars. When Oumuamua was first discovered, it was classified as a comet. However, astronomers started to doubt this classification because it lacked the typical tail of gas and dust that comets usually have when heated by the sun. This led to different speculations among scientists. Some suggested that Oumuamua might be a rocky asteroid or even a new type of interstellar object. Others argued that it could be a planetesimal, a fragment of rock ejected from its original system due to gravitational forces. There was even a notion of it being a zombie comet, or a monstrous, extremely fluffy aggregate, made up of loosely bound dust grains left behind by a disintegrated comet as it approached the sun. Now, you might wonder why all this fascination with comets. Comets provide valuable insights into the early stages of our solar system's evolution. They preserved a snapshot of our solar system's appearance when it formed. So, studying comets is like peering into the past and gaining knowledge about what our solar system used to be like during its early formation stage. Planetary systems interacting with interstellar space can propel tiny particles, known as space pebbles, on long journeys. The prevailing scientific belief is that Oumuamua, an interstellar object that passes through our solar system, is likely a comet. This conclusion is based on its higher-than-expected velocity, which gravitational forces from the Sun cannot solely explain. It is thought that Oumuamua, like a comet, releases gas and dust, creating jets that propel it forward. Interestingly, Oumuamua is about 10 times more reflective than comets from our solar system, possibly due to surface dust being blown off by the outgassing process, revealing shiny ice beneath. The idea of Oumuamua being propelled by jet-driven motion has intrigued astronomers and researchers at SETI, who have searched for any potential technological signals from the object. However, no response has been detected despite two dedicated campaigns. Avi Loeb, from the Harvard-Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics and co-author Shmuela Bayali, proposed an alternative hypothesis suggesting that Oumuamua could be an extremely thin and light sail, utilizing sunlight photons as propulsion. Loeb speculated that Oumuamua might be a discarded piece of space debris, or intriguingly, a purposefully sent exploratory vessel investigating our cosmic neighborhood. Avi Loeb's assertion, while met with skepticism by some scientists, emphasizes the importance of considering valuable theories rather than outright dismissing the possibility of aliens. Now, let's explore how Oumuamua entered our solar system, the Pan-STARRS. One telescope at the University of Hawaii initially detected this celestial object, which had already completed its journey around the Sun and was preparing to depart our solar system. Astronomers worldwide utilized different telescopes to observe Oumuamua for about 4 months until it became too faint to track. There is something about this phenomenon that left scientists scratching their heads. Oumuamua suddenly showed up again and is now heading toward Earth. What puzzled scientists was that Oumuamua didn't fit neatly into existing scenarios, while it exhibited similarities to asteroids which typically move due to gravitational forces, it accelerated as it traveled. This acceleration indicated the presence of a force beyond gravity. The object seemed to experience a pushing effect akin to comets propelled by the evaporation of gas and dust near the Sun. Moreover, the expelled material slightly altered Oumuamua's trajectory, differentiating it from asteroids and planets. However, Oumuamua didn't resemble a typical comet, as it lacked a tail or the gas and dust envelope known as a coma. Consequently, its arrival sparked controversy among astronomers, intensifying scientific curiosity as various models emerged to explain its impressive acceleration. These models hinted at potentially extraordinary chemical properties of the object. Two scientists collaborated to collaborate and test their ideas regarding the acceleration of the interstellar comet known as Oumuamua. They proposed a theory suggesting that Oumuamua could be a water-rich comet moving through the vast space between stars. Over time, the comet's reddish appearance resulted from radiation exposure, which caused hydrogen to form within it. Previous research indicated that ice could transform into molecular hydrogen, implying that a comet's structure might contain hydrogen trapped in bubbles within the ice. The scientists theorized that when Oumuamua was heated by the sun, the gas trapped in the bubbles would be released in a fan-shaped spray, propelling the comet. This explanation could account for Oumuamua's peculiar behavior without requiring exotic chemistry or physics. It also explains the absence of a dusty coma around the comet. Observatories like the James Webb Space Telescope offer the potential to gain more knowledge about comet formation in other planetary systems and expand our understanding of these captivating celestial objects. Astronomers are optimistic about discovering several interstellar comets like Oumuamua every year with the help of the Vera C. Rubin Observatory in Chile, set to open in 2025. Studying these comets from other planetary systems can offer valuable insights into their characteristics. Interestingly, comets and asteroids within our solar system have taught us more about planet formation than the actual planets. The Rubin Observatory's Legacy Survey of Space and Time program will survey the Southern Hemisphere's skies over a decade, and if it had been operational before Oumuamua's passage, we could have detected it much earlier. Although there's no chance of studying Oumuamua up close, scientists hope to catch up with future interstellar objects. The Institute for Interstellar Studies has proposed Project Lyra, aiming to use advanced propulsion technology to study interstellar objects. And if the mission launches in 2028, they may be able to catch up to Oumuamua within 26 years using a sophisticated Jupiter Oberth maneuver. The Initiative for Interstellar Studies, or IFIS, launched Project Lyra soon after Oumuamua's discovery to investigate the possibility of sending a mission to Oumuamua using current or near-future technology. Since then, the I4IS team has conducted further studies on how to catch up with interstellar objects, or ISOs, including exploring the use of nuclear thermal propulsion, or NTP, and a laser sailcraft similar to the Breakthrough Starshot concept, which aims to reach Alpha Centauri within 20 years. In their analysis, previous proposals for reaching Oumuamua using near-future technology suggested a solar Oberth maneuver, or SOM, or the Sundiver concept, which uses the sun's radiation pressure to achieve high velocity. However, this method requires withstanding intense heat by getting as close to the sun as possible. At the core of the solar Oberth maneuver, or SOM and other Oberth maneuvers, lies the technique of gravity assist, which has been employed for exploring the solar system since the early 1970s. This technique utilizes the gravitational forces of three bodies: the spacecraft, a second body, usually a giant planet that provides the assist, and the central body around which the spacecraft's trajectory is controlled. The SOM, in particular, relies on three distinct velocity changes, or impulses, to exit the solar system. These impulses include increasing the spacecraft's distance from the sun at the aphelion, slowing down to approach the sun, and obtaining an additional boost at the perihelion, the closest point to the sun where the spacecraft travels at its fastest. The concept of the three impulses was developed by Theodore Edelbaum in 1959, but the term SOM is still in use. This technique is useful for achieving high speeds when leaving the solar system, and is crucial for catching up with an interstellar object, or ISO, that has passed perihelion and is moving away from the sun. The Parker Solar Probe demonstrated the need for a robust heat shield when approaching the sun, which must withstand extreme heat and radiation. While a heat shield for Project Lyra would differ in size and mass, it would add significantly to the mass of the light sail. A mission to rendezvous with Oumuamua, or Comet 96P/Machholz, holds the potential to yield valuable scientific insights into distant star systems. These missions are considered to be cost-effective and can uncover significant discoveries. Recent investigations have shed light on the unique characteristics of interstellar objects such as Oumuamua, distinguishing them from typical comets due to the absence of common components like carbon and cyanogen. Scientists speculate that these objects may possess a stripped-down nucleus, originating from primordial and interstellar sources. Despite the inherent challenges involved, scientists are optimistic about discovering more interstellar objects following the initial identification of the first interstellar comet and detecting meteors originating from other star systems. The comet known as amateur astronomer Gennady Borisov discovered C2019Q4 aka Borisov in August 2019. Further observations revealed that it followed a hyperbolic orbit, indicating its interstellar origin. With a significantly higher eccentricity and a tilted orbit, The comet's surface properties were likely shaped by millions of years of cosmic ray bombardment during its journey between star systems. Unfortunately, its limited activity and distance from Earth make it challenging to observe, except during perihelion. Although satellite telescopes like SOHO may provide some insights, many mysteries surrounding the comet, including its origin, remain unknown. Borisov reached perihelion on December 8, 2019, at a distance of around 2 AU from the Sun, and its closest approach to Earth occurred on December 28, 2019, at a distance of about 1.8 AU. If you have made this far in the video, consider hitting the subscribe button. Comet 2I/Borisov is heading away from the Sun and will eventually exit our solar system. It's an intriguing interstellar traveler with a hazy gas and dust envelope called a coma, and a tail formed by material pushed away by the solar wind. This comet's nucleus is about 1 kilometer wide, similar to others in our system, but was visible only through large telescopes, reaching a magnitude of 15 in late 2019. Spectroscopic analysis reveals a reddish hue from organic compounds and common cometary substances like water, carbon monoxide, and cyanide. Interestingly, carbon monoxide levels in 2I/Borisov are higher than in typical solar system comets, suggesting an extremely cold origin. Studying this comet helps us understand diverse planetary systems and contributes to our knowledge of Oumuamua, the first interstellar visitor discovered in 2017. While we won't see 2I/Borisov again, future technological advancements may reveal more captivating objects from beyond. For more insights on this interesting phenomenon, click on the video links popping up.